project. This ain't what you want. This ain't what you want.
She wanna be, call me Freaky T. Off the leash, I feel like a dog. I get hella free. Never needed you, but you need me. I got clean, make a pretty clean. Push yourself a thing. I get tough in the moment, so I feel like baby king. For this black, step up something, so I just baby D. Don't cold, cause the SM that you know is giving creep. The hope, and it's not comfort, make a team.
Bye. him. I sent the picture of that nigga to show him I'm only letting him bleed. Shot him, I swung his stick at that, but if they struggle, they hate to
Good afternoon. It's basketball time here in the crown jewel of the Tennessee Valley as the Lady Bulldogs look to defend home court one more time this week as they take on the Lady Devilettes of Mississippi Valley State University. I'm Chauncey Sanders being joined alongside by Jawan Davis. Jawan, it's been a good one so far this week, and the Lady Bulldogs pulled off a huge win to start SWAC conference play this past Monday as they defeated UAPB 67-58.
Yeah, that was a big game led by Ms. Taylor Smith, who really just took over that game for us offensively, especially in that second half with 22 points and then four threes as well. And then also a good game by Ms. Cody, who was helping control the boards. So I'm hoping to look for another game to continue this win streak here in the SWAC.
Definitely. And we also can't go without talking about the amazing shooting performance from the free throw line by the Lady Bulldogs, led by Tony Grace, 10 from 11 from the free throw line, and that definitely proved to be a helping point in the second half.
Yeah, this is the second game she's had in a row with double-digit free throws. She's really been doing a good job of slashing, getting to the paint, and getting to the line. She does a good job of controlling her body and getting good finishes. So if we can continue to do that and then continue to have the shooting that we had, I'm pretty sure that this game plan will roll over pretty well against the Lady Devilettes.
Definitely. Speaking of the Devilettes, they are coming off of a tough loss in Montgomery against Alabama State University. So they're looking to spoil some home court here for the Alabama A&M Lady Bulldogs, including trying to get a win in Alabama, in the state of Alabama, as this will be their second game on the road.
Yeah, well, tough road trip from them. I know they're looking for a W. They had a good game going 8 for 20 from 3, but the one thing that killed them in that game was 20 turnovers. And that's one thing that Coach Richards preaches is defense and helping other teams turn the ball over. So I know that will be on our game plan, and I'd like to see how Coach Anderson adjusts on this second game of this road trip.
Speaking of adjustments, Juwan, the Lady Bulldogs were dominated in the paint in their win against UAPB. 40 points in the paint by the Lady Golden Lions. Also were able to grab 40 rebounds to our 30 as well in the paint. How do you expect Coach Richards and staff to try to adjust coming into this game today?
They have to play like they played in the second half. They have to hustle and get them off the boards early. They have Ms. Harlow, who's second in rebounding, after we just had Ms. Davenport here, who was first. So it's pretty similar situation. So we just need to continue the game plan we had late in that game two days ago against Arkansas Pine Bluff, and just use that same game plan to win out today.
Definitely. When we come back, we'll have the starting lineups and, of course, tip-off right here in Normal, Alabama, as the Lady Bulldogs take on the Devilettes of Mississippi Valley State University.
Play host to the Delta Devils and the Delta Devilettes of Mississippi Valley State University. Introduction of the starting lineups for both teams for the first half of our doubleheader. But first, we ask that you please stand for the playing of our national anthem. And now, here's the starting lineup for the Delta Devilettes of Mississippi Valley State University. Starting at guard, a 5'10 freshman from Little Rock, Arkansas. Number two, Kiana Jones. At guard, a 5'7 senior from Atlanta, Georgia. Number three, Kerrigan Johnson. At forward, a 6'1 junior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Number 11, Zaria Harlow. At guard, a 5'8 junior from Birmingham, Alabama. Number 15, Elisa Saffold. And at guard, a 5'8 senior from Rapid City, South Dakota. Number 21, Lexus Eagle Chasing. The head coach for the Delta Devilettes is Kimberly Anderson, assisted by Jason James and Jaquana Murray. And now, here's the starting lineup for the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M University. Starting at guard, a 5'5 junior from Foster's, Alabama, number 23, Taylor Smith. At guard, a 5'7 junior from Cincinnati, Ohio, number 0, Darian Bergen. At guard, a 5'8 graduate student from Fishers, Indiana, number 4, Tony Grace. At guard, a 6-foot freshman graduate student from Clay, New York, number 3, Amani Free. And at center, a 6'1 junior from Valdosta, Georgia, number 34, Jayla Cody. The head coach for the Bulldogs is Margaret Richards, assisted by Larry McNeil, Nyla Johnson, and Katrina Howard.
And we are underway here in the new event center in Normal, Alabama, on the campus of Alabama A&M University, as the Lady Bulldogs win the tip. Same lineup here for head coach Margaret Richards, as Bergen is along with Smith, Free, Cody, and Grace, who just missed that layup there for the ladies in maroon and white. Three ball is teed up by Saffold. No good. Rebounded by Cody.
And Miss Cody, she's coming off a good game with 9 points, 9 rebounds, 2 steals, 2 blocks. So we'll need another one of those games for her, as this is one of the leading rebounding teams in the SWAC we have tonight.
Three ball is up by Smith. No good. That one touches everything but the rim. Out of bounds. Devilettes basketball. Juwan, last time these ladies met here, the Lady Bulldogs were able to prevail 53-47. Also worth noting, the Lady Bulldogs are riding a 10-game winning streak against the Devilettes.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure Coach will want to continue the streak, especially with this being the first one we have here in the event center. So nice to know that we have a nice win streak going against these girls.
As the Devilettes will start us off here in the new event center with that mid-range good by Saffold. Free looking to drive baseline. Ball knocked out of bounds. Still Lady Bulldog basketball.
We're going to stand right here.
Inbound. Nice pass from Smith to Free. Layup is no good. Ball fought for on the ground, but recovered by Mississippi Valley. Johnson holding the ball up top. She's going to find Harlow. Harlow had a great game in Montgomery. 21 points, 11 rebounds in the loss versus Alabama State.
Yes, yeah, she's becoming one of the top players we have here in women's swag basketball. She's second in rebounding, one of the top scorers, and she's been a real tough guard for a lot of teams earlier. So with conference play starting, I'd like to see how she continue her streak going.
Mid-range is good by Johnson to put the Devilettes up early by four.
Man, with the Devilettes being in this 2-3 zone, three-point shooting is going to be key for our Lady Bulldogs today.
Multiple second chance opportunities there by the Devilettes as well. Something Coach Margaret Richards is not going to be happy about after preaching a rebounding after the game against UAPB.
That's another thing she doesn't want right there is turnovers. We're already being out rebounded, 6 rebounds to 1, so gonna have to pick it up if we're gonna have to slow these Lady Devilettes down.
Quick substitution here for head coach Margaret Richards as Amaya Simmons will check in off the bench. And we're seeing the early adjustments made by the ladies in maroon and white as they now went to a 2-3 zone. Three ball is up. No good by Eagle chasing. Rebounded by Simmons as she's going to be fouled on the floor.
Fouls are going to be something to watch for the Lady Devilettes today. They have a small bench where it looks like only three players being able to come off the bench today. So if we can continue to play how we played against the Pine Bluffs, getting them in foul trouble, it'll be a real tough thing for the Lady Devilettes to overcome.
Fouls could be charged to Jones. It'll be her first as she's subbed out of the game. Checking in for Jones is number 24, and Janae Mick. We'll have a foul on the floor. Foul's going to be charged to Saffold. Devilettes a little aggressive here on the floor. Back-to-back fouls. Smith, nice inbound pass to Free as she's able to get the right-hand layup to go for the ladies in maroon and white.
Yeah, and that was the same look we just had earlier in the game. But just got Amani was able to get her layup to go down this time.
Pass over to Eagle chasing, now back to Saffold. That three ball is good. Smith over to Free, out to Simmons. Free able to find it over to Smith. Three ball is up, no good. Rebounded by Cody. Cody met by two Devilettes. Swings the ball out to Simmons. Free tries a mid-range. That one's too hard. No good. Ball's loose. Saved by Burgeon to Smith. Smith weaving through traffic now. She's going to bring the ball back out. Simmons will try a three ball. No good. Ball is tipped loose. Out of bounds. Lady Bulldog basketball.
And this is a nice offensive position for our Lady Bulldogs. We're getting good looks, but they're not going down. But good job of getting rebounds and giving us more second chance opportunities.
Quick substitution here by the Devilettes and Coach Anderson as Kristen Hunt will check into the ball game. Cody gets the inbound pass over to Burgeon. Simmons in and out over to Smith. Nice ball movement here by the ladies in maroon and white. Burgeon tries to make a move inside. She's going to be pummeled to the ground. Foul's going to be charged to number 11, Zaria Harlow. I'll be her first.
And a lot of quick fouls for the Lady Devilettes. They're already two away from bonus with only half of this game, half of this first quarter being played so far.
At the line for two is number 0, Darian Burgeon. The first free throw is good. Burgeon had a solid outing for the ladies in maroon and white. 5 points, 5 rebounds, but a lot of her plays were made not counting on the box score. A lot of loose balls
fought for. A lot of great defensive plays coming up with loose balls for the ladies in maroon and white.
And she even picked up a couple offensive rebounds late in that game that helped us out.
Fadeaway shot rolls around and falls in for Mech. Three. Sends the ball over to Smith. Now to Burgeon. Over to Simmons. Back to Smith. She'll tee up a three. That one's no good. Rebounded by the Devilettes.
That's her third three-point attempt she's had so far this game. She hasn't been able to get them down, but just like last game, it only takes one for her to get going.
Tough defensive play by Cody. Able to alter the shot. No good. Rebounded by the ladies in maroon and white. Simmons pushes the ball to the floor on the left side. She's going to be ripped away and fouled on the layup attempt. She'll be at the line for two. Fouls going to be charged to Eagle Chasing first. James Ford. We'll have a timeout here on the floor. 4:19 remaining here in the first quarter. The Lady Bulldogs looking to get things going here as they trail 9-4. Welcome back to normal as the Lady Bulldogs trail by five early on in the first half, 9-4. Juwan, what do you think some of the quick adjustments were made in that first timeout by head coach Margaret Richards?
Well, one thing we have been doing better is rebounding. Ever since we noted that we were losing on the rebound battle, we brought it down to just one with 7-6. And we're getting good shot opportunities. They're just not falling down. So we just need to continue doing what we're doing on the offensive side. And on the defensive side, we just need to force a couple more turnovers. We haven't forced any yet today. And with the Lady Devilettes having a 20-turnover game, the last one, they're pretty prone to turnovers. We need to get them to start forcing some.
Both free throws were missed by Simmons as we still have a 5-point ball game. Pass is looking to go back door as Hunt is looking over for Johnson. Turnover there by the Devilettes. Grace over to Simmons. Pass over to McCallop. She'll try a three. She'll knock it down.
Looks like Coach Richards has picked up the pressure coming out of the timeout.
And the ball is loose. Recovered by Simmons. Right hand layup is off the glass and in.
Just like that, a tie game. But like you said, if you want to force turnovers, that's the way to do it right there.
Lady Bulldogs dialing up some pressure out of the timeout break and are cashing in early. Tie ball game. Pass inside for Mech. She'll kick it out for Eagle Chasing. Hill is out of bounds. Maroon and white basketball.
Into the ball game for the Bulldogs. We'll have 44, Donnay Frazier. And into the ball game for the Delta Devilettes.
Checking in for the ladies in maroon and white is number 44, Donnay Frazier. Also, for the Devilettes, it's going to be number 11, Zaria Harlow. Simmons out for Grace. She'll try a three. She knocks it down. Back-to-back threes for the ladies in maroon and white.
Yeah, that's what we got to do to get the Lady Devilettes out that zone. Shoot them out of it.
Layup is no good. Rebounded by Harlow. She'll turn around and try to put it up. No good. Ball is loose. Recovered by McCallop. She's going to push the ball up the floor. Pass is over to Murray. Ball is loose and recovered by the Devilettes. Layup is good and counted with the foul. Saffa will be at the line. Foul's going to be charged to Grace. It'll be Grace's first, team's first. Tough turn of events there, Juwan, by the Lady Bulldogs, as it looked like they were getting ready to go on a run as they knocked down both three-point shots there. They were looking to get the ball inside, and it got broken up. It turned into a transition layup and the foul.
Yeah, and that's one thing you can't let these Lady Devilette team do is get out in transition, especially if you're going to give up an easy layup, not give up an easy free throw with that as well. So just have to clean it up. That's only our second turnover of the game. So as long as we can continue to play clean basketball, we should be all right.
Free throw no good. Simmons mid-range is short. Recovered by Free as she gets the putback to go.
Amani Free!
Pass is up to Jones. Jones trying to go through. Shot is denied by Cody. Three-point attempt is up. No good. Recovered by Hunt. She's going to take a tough fadeaway over Cody. Deflected. How about the defense inside by Cody? Manning down, holding down the middle.
Yeah, great job of her using her length and getting a good contest on that shot.
Free. Dials up a three. She'll drain it.
For three.
How about the Lady Bulldogs shooting the skin off the basketball early on here in the first half?
And not only are we hitting threes, but it's been three different Bulldogs for each one. So nice to see that it's a team effort from the three-point line so far in this game.
Ball is tipped by Free, stolen by Free. She's pushing the pace. She's in transition. Tough left-handed shots, no good. Off the bottom of the hoop as the ball was recovered by the Devilettes, mid-range is no good by Hunt, but she'll be at the line for two as she's going to be fouled. Foul's going to be charged to McCullup. It'll be her first, team second. Quick substitution here by both sides. Checking in for the Devilettes is number 21, Alexis Eagle Chasing. Also, for the ladies in maroon and white, Smith is going to return back into the ballgame as well as Grace. Also, late substitution is Donnie Frazier checking in for Cody. How about that play from Cody, though, Juwan? What an exciting play she had down there defensively, able to get a block. And then, although her teammates weren't able to recover the block, she was still able to deflect the shot and help out on that second chance opportunity that the Devilettes thought they had.
And that's what she's been doing so far, especially in that coming off this game against the Golden Line. She's been doing a good job of replacing Dariana, giving us some size down low. She does a good job of blocking shots, and she's a great rebounder as well. So nice effort play right there by her to keep our Lady Bulldogs' energy up.
Free over to Grace. Less than 10 seconds now on the clock. Grace turns, takes a wide open mid-range. Too hard, no good. Recovered by Frazier. Put back is in.
Donnie Frazier.
Shot clock is off for the Devilettes. Eagle Chasing tries a three ball up top. No good. Recovered by Smith. 10 seconds now left in the first quarter. Head coach Margaret Richards directed traffic, telling Smith to go. Between the leg crossover. Tough right hand shot off the glass. It's good. Before the horn. That will do it for the first quarter. The Lady Bulldogs have went on a run. Smoking hot. What a way to end the first quarter as the Lady Bulldogs hold on to the lead after 121-12.
What she saying? I heard blah blah. Wata rocks on me like I'm Tata. Baba sipping like it's aqua. Pop up before you chopper. Chopper when it busts, you hear papa. Doctor serving patients. I'm a trapper. Rasta. I've been running with some shots. Go smoke a shark lotto in a fish bowl. Wearing Prada. Got a drink bottle from the doctor. Riding with an NLE chopper. Feed.
Hop on the bitch and I said what I said. Too much blue money to go on the red. Yeah. Better get little, start using your legs. Pop, 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 hit at your head. Pop, mad at the that she up for grabs. Single and thirsty, bougie and ghetto. Yeah. Don't wanna let go of me like a ego. Nope. Good sound like you staring at Fredo. This is can't eat no Jello. I heard he got hit with a carbon Carmelo. Haters be hot, but my chain below zero. Money keep calling, I answer like hello. Yo. La, la, ha, ha. Laugh to the bank, I'm like, ha, ha, da, da. What she saying? I heard blah, blah. Wata, rocks on me like I'm Tata. Baba, sipping like it's aqua. Pop up. Before you chopper, chopper. When it bust, you hear popper. Doctor, serving patients, I'm a trapper. Roster, I've been running with some shotters. Whole lot of hundreds in the safe. Blue. Way more 20s in the vacuum seal. What else? Be cool, not straight. Get no handshake if I know you squeal. Well, made money playing safe. Go out. Had to take them risks, kick those and steal. Go. My little men dedicated on the drill. Out. Later, I'm like 12 on the tears. Swallow, goggle, all in the map like some tonsils. Mom, security, kids, she caught them. After you done, just leave all them. Send to your friend the thing you brought. Yeah. Mama keep calling. What? Since you don't act like you got no sense. Like you got money, funny, money, funny, money, funny, money, funny.
Welcome back to normal as the Lady Bulldogs hold on to a 21-12 lead to start the second quarter. Juwan, the Lady Bulldogs put together a 73 run in the last 5:02 of that first quarter. How exciting was that to see the closing of the first quarter?
Yeah, and that was around the time we had that timeout. It seemed like once we came out of there, Coach Richard said something to give us some energy. We started forcing turnovers, started grabbing more rebounds. Then the three-point shots. We had three different Lady Bulldogs hit a three-point shot, and then we had Ms. Smith, who hasn't had a shot all game, do what she does best for this team and go get a bucket at the end of the quarter and to get her going. So nice to see that our offense and defense is flowing nice so far in this game.
Hunt was able to get the layup to go. She cuts the lead to 7, 21-14. Virgin inside the free, high-low action over to Cody. Turns, layup off the glass, and in. Perfect execution by the ladies in maroon and white.
Yeah, and that's where you want Jayla catching the ball, right under the goal in the restricted area where all she has to do is get a good move off and get an easy bucket.
Valley is able to get the ball into the forecourt. Three ball is up, no good. Recovered by Hunt as she gets the pass inside to the teammate. That layup is good by Mick. Tough play there by A&M. Three ball went long and right into the hands of a Devilette, and they were able to capitalize off of it.
Yeah, with us being in that zone, that's one thing that we'll be prone to give up is offensive rebounds, with us not being able to just man up and box out.
Smith will try a three. It's good! Off the second chance opportunity.
Just like last game, when it came to the second quarter, all it takes is for one for her to get going. So you'll see if you can continue this on.
Hunt on the wing. Crosses over, spins, tough left-handed layup, no good, out of bounds. Maroon and white basketball.
Into the ball game for the Delta Devilettes, number 2, Kiriana Jones for the Bulldogs, number 11, Bonnie Simmons.
Checking in for the ladies in maroon and white, it's going to be number 11, Amaya Smith. Simmons, excuse me. Grace over to Cody. Nice fake by Cody. Caught her a bird, and the layup is good.
Jayla Cody.
Nice move right there by Jayla. Getting her defender in and getting a nice, easy finish. Playing great basketball so far in this game.
Jones over to Johnson. Nice ball movement here by the Devilettes. Eagle chasing. 10 seconds left now on the shot clock. Turns, finds a teammate in desperation as the layup was good by Johnson. Wide open on the left side of the floor.
Yeah, that was a good job of her reading her teammate and cutting right behind her to get a nice easy layup.
Urgent over to Simmons. Cross court pass to Smith. Hesitated on a three. Nice ball movement here by the ladies in maroon and white. Virgin gets inside, tough scoop layup, no good. Rebounded by Cody, not able to clean up on the second chance opportunity. That time the layup fell short. Still a 10-point ball game, 28-18. Mick spins, tough shot. Took an extra step to get open as she gets the right-hand shot to go inside. Now a single-digit ball game. Lady Bulldogs still lead by 8, 28-20. Grace tries a 3. No good. Too hard. Ball is tipped and recovered by Grace. Grace will try a mid-range. That one's no good. Ball is loose. Recovered by Cody. Extra seconds here on the shot clock. Smith hesitates, gets inside, tries a floater. That one is deflected. This time the Devil Lettes will take over on this one. Hunt thought about a 3, kicks it back out to Johnson as they'll reset the offense. Meck tries a 2, long 2. She gets that one to go. Timeout. Head coach Margaret Richards. With 5:36 remaining in the first half, the Lady Bulldogs still hold on to a 6-point lead, 28-22. Welcome back to normal as the Lady Bulldogs hold on to a 6-point lead, 28-22. Juwan, it's been a tough 2 minutes for the Lady Bulldogs as they have been held scoreless as the Devilettes have went on an early 6-0 run here. What do you think Coach Margaret Richards was preaching in that timeout break?
Well, one thing we need to do, we're getting good looks, like I've been saying, we just have to continue to shoot the ball. And then on the defensive side, we need to get Meck out of her comfort zone. She was doing a good job of getting some nice rebounds. They're doing a good job of getting some mid-range jumpers off, and she was just knocking them down. So we just have to do a good job of playing how we were before that first timeout and continue to force some more turnovers.
As Frazier is able to break the dry spell, but she got the layup to go. Harlow out to Hunt. She'll try a 3. She'll knock down a 3.
And that's the Lady Devilettes. That's their first 3 since the first quarter. We've been doing a good job of, even with us being in the zone and switching out, with getting them off the 3-point line.
That pass is broken up as the Devilettes try to capitalize off the turnover. Harlow catches the high pass out to Eagle chasing. She'll try a 3. That one is good. What once was a 10-point lead is now cut to just 2.
And it's been from defense and shooting for the Lady Devilettes, especially on that last position. It seemed like we just dared her to shoot that one.
Simmons will try a 3 of her own. The bottom! Big answer from Simmons as she breaks the lead back to 5.
Yeah, we needed that. We haven't scored in the last 3 minutes. We needed some offense going for us.
Hunt, she's feeling herself now as she knocks down the mid-range.
Yeah, and the Lady Devilettes, they're doing a good job of spacing out their scoring. They have 3 players near in double-digit scoring with the 3 minutes left in the second quarter.
3! Sees her 3-pointer go down the bottom of the net. As we'll have a timeout by head coach Kimberly Anderson, the Lady Bulldogs are still holding on to a 6-point lead with 3:33 remaining in the first half. Don't touch that dial yet. It's women's basketball here on the Alabama A&M Athletics YouTube live stream. Straightening, 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 yeah.
straining. Yeah. Don't not get straining but straining. Hey. Don't not get straining but straining. Don't not get straining but straining. You don't get you straight, you straight. Now this gang sit back, be patient. Gang. Act like the gang went vacant. Act like something been taken.
Took what?
Ain't nothing but
first horn. First horn.
Out daily. Good. On the island, it's a movie I'm making. I'm counting the narrows with Robert De Niro. He telling them that you're amazing. Get down. I bought two whips and I put my foot on. She put this wrist on. She fits on. She fits on.
Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as the Lady Bulldogs hold on to a 6-point lead, 36-30. What a huge three by Free before the timeout break. Shot is up and is good by Jones.
Yeah, her and Amaya did a good job of answering back with Mississippi Valley knocking down some threes of their own. So nice to see that we're shooting well today. We're 6-for-11 from three. I know Coach Richards would be happy with that.
Simmons, nice pass over to McCallum. Passes inside to Cody. She'll take a pass out to Burgeon for three. The bottom!
Coach Papa be happy with that ball movement right there. A lot of extra passes. Jayla could have went up with the contested layup, but she seen Darian in the corner. And nice three knockdown for her.
If you don't love that possession there, you don't love basketball. The unselfishness by this Lady Bulldog team was on full display just a second ago, with the amount of passing we saw, the passing out of double teams, and leading to open players.
And that's composure and patience, doing a good job of not letting the defense flush you and giving what they give, giving what the defense takes, taking what the defense gives you. My bad.
Pass is inside for Jones, out of the inbound. She finds Hunt. Hunt trips, falls, swings the ball over to Harlow. Still plenty of time left for the Devilettes. Now with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Harlow at the free throw line. Kicks the ball over to Jones. She'll try a corner three. No good. Ball is rebounded by Harlow. Loses it. Nice strip by Burgeon. Able to get that ball loose.
Well, you've been doing a good job of keeping Miss Harlow in the cage game. That's only her second rebound. She hasn't scored yet.
Free. Three ball is no good. Cody trying to race to save the ball on a long rebound. No, she's not able to recover that. Devilettes basketball. Nearing 2 minutes left in the first half. Eagle chasing has the basketball. Quick kick over to Hunt. Hunt on the pick and roll. Layup is no good by Harlow, but we're going to have a blocking foul. Foul's going to be charged to Burgeon. That'll be Burgeon's first. This will be the Lady Bulldogs' second. We'll have a quick substitution here by head coach Margaret Richards, checking into the ballgame. It's number 23 in Taylor Smith. Also checking in for the Devilettes is number 24, Anjanae Meck. First free throw, no good by Harlow. Second of the pair is good. As we mentioned earlier, the Lady Bulldogs have won the last 10 meetings between these two programs, being the latest last season, winning 53-47 on January 12th. Three ball is up by Hunt and is good, right down the twine. 3-point ball game here in Normal.
And shooting is picked up for both teams. Both teams have been doing a good job of knocking down the three by.
Pass is tipped by Eagle Chasing, trying to save it. She's able to find Harlow. Here come the Devilettes. One possession ball game. Hunt feeling herself, deep three. She tickles the twine. Timeout, head coach Margaret Richards, as we are knotted at 39. 39 all here with a little over 1 minute remaining in the first half. We'll be right back after the break.
sipping it fast. Press on your book and I press on the gas. Bad, body bad. She rocks on my dick and she do with no hands. Look up the ceiling, I'm throwing up, telling, I'm throwing up, telling, I'm throwing up, telling, I'm throwing up, telling.
Welcome back to normal as we are knotted up at 39. Tough break defensively for the ladies in maroon and white, Juwan.
Yeah, it's from the Lady Devilettes picking it up on the three-point line. They 4-for-6 in this quarter after shooting 1-for-6 in the first, and they're doing a good job of forcing turnovers as well. So need to run them off that three-point line. That really became a factor in them coming back.
Nice pass from McCallop inside for Cody for the easy two. 41-39. Eagle chasing. Cross-court pass over to Hunt. Have to keep a hand in her face. She's been on fire in the last 3 minutes. Tough mid-range is up. Deflected. Great defense by Cody. Ball was out of bounds on recovery by Simmons. Devilettes basketball. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. 25.9 seconds left in the game. Johnson inbounds the ball over to Harlow. Deep mid-range, no good. Rebounded by the ladies in maroon and white. McCallop pushing the pace now. She's going to slow it up. Nice awareness to see the shot clock turned off. Over to Smith. Looking for one possession here. One last possession to end the half. Back to Smith. 5 seconds left on the clock. She drives. Tough shot. Off the glass. No. As Harlow rebounds the basketball. That will do it at the horn. As the Lady Bulldogs go into the first half, holding on to a 2-point lead, 41-39. It's been a really impressive first half. As you see, head coach Margaret Richards wanting to preach in that break there before the Lady Bulldogs headed out to the locker room on just keeping your head up, keeping your awareness. It seemed like she saw something there in that last possession that the girls on the floor didn't see.
Yeah, and it's just been a game of run so far for us. We started the game off good, had a nice run to start off the game with a double-digit lead, but the Lady Devilettes didn't let that fluster them and get them out their groove, as once the second quarter started up, they got high. They were shooting 66% from the three and 68% from the team after just shooting 31% in the first quarter. So they picked it up offensively, and while we've been playing great defensively, when a team scores 27 in the quarter, you have to find a way to slow them down. So I'm pretty sure Coach Richards will be game planning to find a way to slow these Lady Devilettes down.
As that will do it for us here at the half. The Lady Bulldogs hold on to a 2-point lead, 41-39. Don't touch that dial yet. Juwan is going to give us his first half adjustment, as well as what we should expect from the ladies in maroon and white. It's the Alabama A&M Athletics YouTube live stream. We'll be right back after the break.
I'll be jumping crazy. I'll be getting Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical Student Health and Wellness Center. It offers top-notch gym experience to help maintain a healthy lifestyle. With over 50 five-star rated commercial and consumer equipment, keeping that unwanted weight down is a breeze. Water aerobics and swimming lessons are offered in the six-lane heated swimming pool, topped with ceiling-high window walls for a beautiful array of sunlight. Sign up today for Zumba, yoga, martial arts, and dance aerobics classes. AAMU Wellness Center also gives the opportunity to indulge in extracurricular activities for burning extra calories on top of your workout, including volleyball, basketball, track, and racquetball. Have some fun after your workout in the state-of-the-art six-lane bowling alley. Enjoy a nice, refreshing smoothie alongside with an inexpensive, nutritious meal from the juice bar. Equipped with blazing fast Wi-Fi, book one of the event rooms for meetings and fellowship of any occasion. Alabama A&M Student Health and Wellness Center, where service is sovereignty.
Companies hunger for our food scientists. Here, a new generation manages our cities of tomorrow. The discovery of hardier plants, healthier animals, is growing at our research station, Alabama A&M University, where new designs and ideas are put to the test. Be a researcher in our labs, or a forestry fire dog in our fields. Alabama A&M University. Start here. Go anywhere.
Psychology on the golf course and in the classroom. No hurdles too high for Raven on the track or in nutrition. Alabama A&M, 4 years of artistic, academic, and athletic discovery. We deliver the full university experience. Alabama A&M University. Start here. Go anywhere.
At Alabama A&M University, you will find people that come from all walks of life come to a school enriched in history, join together for a common goal to strive for academic excellence. AAMU have beautiful scenery and wonderful programs such as the athletics department for students interested in sports. Come witness our founder's dream become a reality through the Bulldog experience.
The Alabama A&M Health and Wellness Center is here to meet your fitness needs with swimming, volleyball, basketball, racquetball, and bowling. We offer full weight and cardio rooms with state-of-the-art equipment and access to a variety of classes, such as yoga, Zumba, boxing, and more. Cool off with a refreshing beverage from our juice bar. Book one of our meeting rooms for events of any occasion.
AAMU Wellness Center is now a proud participant of the Silver Sneakers program.
It's not just for students, it's for you too.
Call 256-372-7000 for more information. Start here. Go anywhere with Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical Student Health and Wellness Center. It offers top-notch gym experience to help maintain a healthy lifestyle. With over 55...
Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as the Lady Bulldogs hold on to a two-point lead, 41-39. Chauncey Sanders here being joined alongside by my partner in crime, Juwan Davis. Juwan, it's been an eventful first half, to say the least, as the Lady Bulldogs inbound the ball to start the second half. What can we expect coming out of the halftime break from the ladies in maroon and white?
Well, it's been a pretty even game so far. Both teams have 19 rebounds. We have forced one more turnover with five to our four, and we both knocked down over five threes. But the three-point shooting has really been the key point for us offensively. We're already nearing the most threes we've hit in a game all season, and it's just been the first half. So we need to continue to shoot how we're shooting. But one thing we can do is force more turnovers. Like I said earlier, this team had 20 turnovers just earlier this week. So if we could force more turnovers and get out in transition like we were earlier when we went on that 10, had a 10-point lead and went on that run, I feel like we'll be able to extend this lead out a little more.
Pass earlier on for the Lady Bulldogs. First possession was a little bit too much inside. Turnaround shot is no good. However, Meck is going to be at the line for two as she was fouled on that turnaround jump shot.
Yeah, she's been one of the key scorers for this Lady Devilette team. She has 8 points, with a lot of them coming in that second quarter, especially in the mid-range with those jump shots. So she can get to double-digit points right now with these two free throws.
First free throw is no good. Nice jinx there by Juwan.
Yeah, we need some of that going the other way. It's too many times we jinx ourselves.
Courtesy of yours truly and head coach Van Petaway. I also love, just as we've been looking to break down the first half, the Lady Bulldogs have been a difference of night and day in the paint so far today in this game versus UAPB, where the Lady Golden Lions were able to put up 40 points in the paint.
Yeah, it's nice to see that, especially with Jayla and Amani just doing a good job of using their size and making it tough for the Lady Devilettes to get inside on them.
As we'll have a foul as the shot clock was winding down for the Lady Bulldogs, as Cody will be at the line for two. Foul's going to be charged to Harlow. That'll be her third, team's first.
Yeah, we were just praising the Lady Bulldog team for the last couple games getting to the free throw line, and we've only had 4 free throw attempts so far in this game. So I'd like to see if we can take advantage of the Devilettes' aggression they've been having and get to the line and get a couple more easy ones.
First free throw is no good from Cody. Second free throw no good, but the ball is rebounded by Bergen, as she kicks the ball out to Smith. Free, wide open, takes a long mid-range, the bottom.
She's been having a good game. She's the leading scorer for us, with that now being her 12th point of the game. So nice to see Amani stepping up for this Lady Bulldog team.
Nice, the ball is tipped away by Grace as the Lady Bulldogs control it. Bergen driving baseline, turns. Kicks the ball out for Grace. She'll fake. Takes a tough drive out to Free. Mid-range is up. It's good.
She's doing her best Taylor impression. Her really picking up here from the second quarter with scoring.
Hunt over to Meck. Cross-court pass is broken up and stolen by Grace. How about the defense by Tony Grace early on here in the second half, able to come up with two steals. Grace wide open for three. No good. Rebounded by Harlow.
Yeah, not only a great steal, but great hustle to keep that ball in and give us a possession.
45-39. Devilettes looking to slow the ball up here, slow the pace. Trying to find a good possession the last two times have resulted in a turnover. Mid-range is up. No good. Rebounded by Cody. Over to Smith as she pushes the ball up the floor. Let's see head coach Margaret Richards giving some direction. Bergen over to Free. Over to Grace, inside to Cody. Cody to Free. Tough layup, no good by Free on the cut, but she'll be at the line for two. Foul is going to be on Harlow. That'll be her fourth. team second. Not good for Coach Kimberly Anderson and the Devilettes.
Yeah, this their leading scorer, their leading rebounder, and she's also coming off a big game. And she has early foul trouble with three so far in this game, with only being 6 minutes and 50 seconds into this third quarter.
Free. First free throw is good. She has had herself a game today. 6 of 10 from the field, along with 3 rebounds, 2 assists, and a steal as she knocks down the second of the pair. 47-39 here in Normal. Long pass is out over to Saffold. Saffold up top to Johnson. Nice ball movement here by the Devilettes. Three ball is up. No good by Eagle chasing. Smith over to Grace. She'll tee up a three. She'll knock it down. Eagle chasing, met by a trap. Ball is loose, tipped away, knocked out of bounds. As Smith almost had herself an easy steal, wide open on the right side as well. Could have been potentially an open right-hand layup.
Yeah, even though we didn't get the steal right there, we're hustling. Just like you were saying, what we needed in the second half, we needed some good defense and good turnovers. And we've seen that in these last couple of possessions for our Lady Bulldogs.
Checking into the ball game for the ladies in maroon and white is Imagine McCollop, as well as Simmons. Also, Fresh Face is back on the floor. Good to see her back on the floor is Chanel Mitchell. As the ball was loose for a second, 5 seconds left for the Devilettes. Tough mid-range, no good. Ball is knocked around by two Lady Bulldogs, but is recovered by the ladies in maroon and white. Free. Fakes inside for Mitchell. Tough shot, no good, but she'll be at the line as she goes crashing, gone to the floor.
And she's making her presence be known early. We haven't seen too much of her this season. Nice to see her back in, but she's already making an early impact getting to the free throw line.
Quick substitution here by Coach Anderson and the Devilettes as Mech will check into the ball game for Jones. Mitchell has missed action against the Pine Bluff Lady Golden Lions. It's great to see her back on the floor. First free throw is no good. As we can now take a look ahead in the schedule, January 7th, the Lady Bulldogs will travel to Lorman, Mississippi to take on the Lady Braves of Alcorn State University. We're also going to stay in Mississippi to take on the Lady Tigers of the I Love Jackson State University on January 9th. Second free throw was good, 51-39. A little over 5 minutes remaining. Pass was a little bit too much for Eagle chasing. She's able to still kick out the pass over for her teammate. Three ball no good in the corner from Johnson. Ball out of bounds. Maroon and white basketball. Caleb fakes over to Simmons. Simmons hesitates. Left hand layup off the glass. It's good. Amaya Simmons.
Yeah, great take right there by Maya. Being aggressive and getting a nice easy layup with the left.
Eagle chasing. Over to Hunt. Hunt. Cross court pass. Over to Saffold. Now back to Hunt. Nice ball movement here from the Devilettes. Mid-range is up by Mech and is knocked down.
Yeah, that's been her bread and butter so far today. That jump shot to, right above the free throw line has really been her bread and butter for her.
Simmons, tough drive between two Devilettes. No good. She's able to hold on to her own rebound. McCallop, nice pass inside to Cody. She'll fake. Tough play out to McCallop. She'll drive inside. Layup bounces around. It's good. Counted and a foul. What a play by the young lady as she was unselfish early on the play, had a wide open shot up top, kicks it down low to Cody, and Cody rewards her with the pass back for the easy layup off the glass and the foul.
Yeah, a lot of unselfish play from my Lady Bulldogs, and we've been seeing a lot of good.
Good, she's able to hold on to her own rebound. McCallop, nice pass inside to Cody, she'll fake. Tough play out to McCallop, she'll drive inside. Layup bounces around, it's good! Count it and a foul! Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, here on the campus of Alabama A&M University, as McCallop looks to take advantage of the three-point play the hard way, as she was able to get her layup to go through the contact and the whistle as she does just that.
Yeah, with that three, we're having one of our best offensive performances we've had so far this season. Hit the most threes we hit all season with 8, and we're nearing the most points we've had all season with 68, which is a good improvement for us, with us being surprisingly last in the SWAC when it comes to offensive scoring.
Burgeon, tough drive, layup is no good, but she'll be at the line for 2. Foul's going to be charged to Saffold. They'll be her first, team's 5th. Yes, that foul will put Burgeon at the line. Darian has been having herself a solid day, 5-5 in the last game versus UAPB, but she came up with a lot of hustle plays, and today it's been looking the same way. She's been a part of this aggressive group, helping leading the charge for now a 17-point lead after the pair of free throws.
Yeah, she's a great leader for this Lady Bulldog team. She runs the point well, she plays unselfish, and she also gives a great energy, great hopes, and one of our better perimeter defenders we have on the team.
Hunt stops, pops, and knocks it down. As that stops a dry spell.
And that's the player we need to slow down. We slowed her down so far in this third quarter. She had 14 points going into the second half, but she has a 16-point game and 3 for 3 for 3.
Pass is broken up and knocked away as Mech will take the fancy finish on the solo transition play after the steal, 58-45. Murray over to Simmons. Simmons surveying the floor. Nice crossover over 3. Devilettes, no good. Murray's able to clean it up as she's going to be fouled on the putback. So we'll have a substitution here. The head coach, Margaret Richards, checking back into the ball game. It's Donne Frazier. As Jalen Murray will be at the line for 2.
And it's nice to see that we picked it up. One thing that we said with those adjustments was that we weren't going to the free throw line enough, and this will be our 10th and 11th free throw of the second half, with us only having 4 in the first.
As Murray knocks down the pair. She'll check out. Subbing in for Alabama A&M is going to be Tony Grace. Monty Free has been having a great season thus far, starting all games, putting up great numbers, a 77% free throw shooter, and she's had a great game today, automatic from the perimeter. Three ball is up, no good, rebounded by Free. Free pushing the pace now. But she'll kick the ball over to Smith. 15-point ball game, 60-45.
And this is a season-high game for Amani, matching her season-high with 19, but they're still having plenty of time to live. She's having one of her best offensive games of the season.
Frazier able to recover the pass, nearly broken up by Meck. 5 seconds now on the clock for A&M. Smith loses the ball, tries to recover it. Tough shot off the ground. Unable to touch the rim as she's still laying there on the floor. Shot clock violation.
Yeah, that's the player you want with the ball in your hands for our Lady Bulldog team with this much time left in the shot clock. Just was a tough wasn't able to get a shot off from some tough defense.
Eagle chasing, tough pass inside. It's broken up by Free. Still Devilettes basketball with 18 seconds left on the shot clock. Inside to Meck. And she'll kick it out for Hunt. Hunt, tough contested three, no good. Rebounded by Frazier. A little over a minute and a half here in the second half, in the third quarter. Free tries a mid-range. That one rolls around and is out. Frazier able to save the ball, but into the hands of a Devilette. Nice hustle by Frazier. Hunt trying to take advantage of the 5-on-4 play. Meck, tough fadeaway. That one bounces across the rim. No good. Grace has the ball knocked out of her hands as she recovers. Tough right-hand drive. Knocked away by Eagle chasing. Off the body of Grace and out of bounds, Devilettes basketball. Guess we'll have a quick substitution here as Cody checks in for Alabama A&M. Less than a minute remaining here in the third quarter. Hunt gets the screen, looking for the roller, nothing there. Passes inside for Meck. Less than 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Eagles chasing. Tough drive, no good. Offensive foul. What a play by Simmons.
Yeah, good job for Amaya using her defensive position and letting the offensive player coming to her and drawing that charge. And now we have a chance to extend this lead going into the fourth.
Checking in for Mississippi Valley was number 22, Naomi Gillard. Less than 10 seconds now left in the third quarter. Simmons, tough left-hand drive off the glass. She gets it to go. Ball is loose and recovered, but not enough time left for Simmons to take advantage of the turnover, as that will do it for the third quarter. The Lady Bulldogs holding on to a commanding lead, 62-45. Don't touch that dial yet. You're watching women's basketball here on the Alabama A&M Athletics YouTube live stream. Yeah, you heard about me. You don't know me more than that. Yeah, I know. They'll come back to normal as we kick off the final quarter here for the ladies game as Hunt driving, gets inside for Mech. Tough layup, no good through Cody. Second attempt is good as the ball bounces around and falls in. Lady Bulldogs still holding on to a commanding lead here. 62-47, Juwan. How about that third quarter by the Lady Bulldogs as they were able to get a run going early on in the third quarter and they just really didn't look back.
That was a great quarter for us. They outscored the Devilettes 22-6. They got to the free throw 11 times to their two. But that two they had was on their first possession of the second half. So they just did a good job of flipping the switch, upping their aggressiveness. They forced more turnovers in the second half than they did in the whole first half. So they're just doing a good job of playing Bulldog basketball. If they can continue this intensity, we'll be able to cruise out to a good victory.
Also, Harlow having to be a big factor despite that three falling, as she's been having to sit out majority of the second half with four fouls early on in that third quarter.
Yeah, with us playing that aggressive, we took their best player off the court. She's, like we said, second in the SWAC in rebounding. She's one of the top scorers in the SWAC. And just with playing aggressive and getting them in foul trouble, we neutralized them.
Grace's layup is no good. Pass over to Johnson. Three ball is up in the corner. No good. Rebounded by Eagle chasing. But we're going to have an offensive foul that'll be charged on to Lexus. That'll be Eagles chasing's third, team's first. We'll have a quick substitution here by head coach Margaret Richards as Darian Bergen will check in for Simmons. Simmons had a huge play to end the third quarter with the left-hand layup. Also was able to create an offensive foul on the defensive end.
Yeah, good all-around game for her. She has that charge, she drew, she has a steal. She's also knocked down a three, so she's given us a little bit of everything in this game, and this really meant a good team-oriented game for the Lady Bulldogs.
Grace had the ball fall off of her leg, trying to catch it. 10 seconds left on the clock. Met by two Devilettes. She's able to kick it out for Smith. Smith, step back three, no good. Rebounded by the Devilettes. Johnson inside for Eagles chasing as her shot fell short, out of bounds. Maroon and white basketball. So we'll have a substitution here by both teams. Checking in first for Mississippi Valley State. The number 11, Zaria Harlow, as we mentioned earlier on here in this fourth quarter. She missed majority of that third quarter, being in foul trouble. We'll keep an eye on her with four fouls. And for the Lady Bulldogs, Armani Free. Free steps into a mid-range. She's going to be met with contact on the landing of that shot. She'll be at the line for two.
And with these two free throws, she has a chance to have her first 20-point game of the season. She's really been a key factor in this game with defense and helping neutralize Ms. Harlow when she's on the court and also on the offensive side knocking down not only threes but nice mid-range jumpers as well.
Free first free throw falls in. And she knocks down the second of the pair. Hunt crosses over, kicks the ball over to Harlow. Tough shot, denied by Cody. 16 seconds left on the shot clock for the Devilettes. Pass is unable to meet Harlow. Racing down the floor, Smith. Tough right hand layup is off the glass and in.
Taylor.
Yeah, good job from Taylor taking advantage of the miscommunication and helping extend his lead out.
Tough play for the Devilettes. Mech over to Hunt. She'll step back, takes a deep three. No good over two Lady Bulldogs. Ball is knocked out of bounds. He'll stay here with the Devilettes. 20 seconds left one, the shot clock to work. We'll have a quick timeout here on the floor in Normal as the Lady Bulldogs hold on to a 16-point lead, 66-50.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Can't feel this void between us. I cannot stand losing you. Whoa, whoa. All these feelings intertwined. Oh, fighting the urge to reach out. And my stance remains unchanged, baby. I can't help it, I'm so into you.
Welcome back to the New Event Center, the crown jewel of the Tennessee Valley, as the Lady Bulldogs hold on to a 16-point lead, as we'll have an offensive foul called off of the inbound play. Foul will be charged to Mech.
And it's just been a tough second half for this Devilette team. They kept up with us for the most part, but with turnovers like that, it's just been real tough for them to cut down the lead.
Callup over to Bergen. She'll fake. Gets inside. Tries to get a pass to Cody through contact. Cody's able to come up with it. Over to McCallop for three. She'll knock it down. Big time three from the freshman. Dash is inside for Harlow. She turns. Tough left hand layup. No good. Touches everything but the rim. As the Lady Bulldogs will bring the ball up the floor. McCallop over to Free. Looks inside for Cody. She's able to corral it. Left hand layup is off the glass and good.
Cody.
Lady Bulldogs have broken this thing open into a 21-point lead.
Yeah, been a great game for our Lady Bulldogs, offensively and defensively. I know this is a game Coach Rich has wanted for us and her Lady Bulldog team, especially with this being still early in the SWAC season.
As we'll have a foul on the floor. Foul's going to be charged to Cody. That'll be Cody's third. Team second. Checking in for the Lady Bulldogs is going to be number 44, Donnay Frazier. Mech drives, tough right hand shot is no good. Rebounded by Harlow as she's being hounded down low. She's going to be called for a travel.
You took 2 minute steps.
As the Devilettes have been held scoreless for the last 3:25. Great defense here by the ladies in maroon and white. Free takes open a wide open three, no good. Rebounded by Frazier. She's going to be clobbered to the floor on the second chance opportunity. She'll be at the line for two. How about the play from Frazier, the freshman big, as she was able to come up with that tough offensive rebound as she went up for two. She was clobbered down as she'll be at the line now.
Yeah, it's been a good official game for Ms. Frazier. She As soon as I said it, she missed the free throw, but she's 2-for-2 from the field goal with 4 points and 6 rebounds, but only playing 6 minutes. So she's making good use of her minutes. I know Coach Richards liked that, especially with her being the freshman, this being her first SWAC season.
Second of the pair is good as she pushes the lead to 22. Eagle chasing. Try a deep three as that one touches the bottom of the net.
Eagle chasing.
Caleb. Over to Murray. Nice ball movement here from the ladies in maroon and white. Simmons. Tough spin. Kicks out for Murray. She'll try an open mid-range. That one is in and out. Pass is loose and recovered by Imagine McCallum. Over to Frazier. High layup is no good. Rebounded by Harlow. Harlow pushing the break now. Harlow on the baseline drive. Spins in a two. Lady Bulldog defenders. As she kicks the ball out to Saffold, she'll bring the ball out and regroup things. Eagle chasing. Tough layup, no good through the contact. As she'll be at the line for two. Foul's going to be charged to Murray. That'll be Murray's first. Team's third. As we'll have a timeout here on the floor. 4:16 remaining here in the final quarter. The Lady Bulldogs holding on to a huge lead at home. 72-53. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as the Lady Bulldogs hold on to a 72-53 lead with a little over 4 minutes remaining here in the ball game. Juwan, the Lady Bulldogs have been on fire. They have dominated this ball game in almost every category.
Yeah, especially with rebounding. That's one thing we've been preaching, both of us saying before the game, is that we need to rebound and force turnovers, and we're winning both battles with us forcing 13 turnovers and out-rebounding about six, as we gave up one right there. But it's been a great performance so far from our Lady Bulldogs.
Murray pass is broken up as the Devilettes take advantage of the turnover. Saffold. Emphatically put that layup in through the contact and foul. She'll have an opportunity for one.
Yeah, it's been the best offensive spurt for this Lady Devilette team so far in the second half. They're trying to pick it up and cut into this lead, but as long as the Lady Bulldogs can continue to be patient, not give up the ball like they did right there, and just drain the shot clock down, we'll still be able to walk out with this one.
6-0 run in the last minute for the Devilettes. Cody gets the ball in the forecourt, met by two Devilettes. Ball is tied up. Possession will remain with the Lady Bulldogs. Alabama A&M. It's just one of their last four field goals. Simmons drives, kicks the ball out to McCallop. She'll fake. Cross-court pass over to Bergen. Able to catch the high pass
Now 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Free will try a deep three. That one off the rim, no good. Ball is tipped, saved by Cody. But Cody is out of bounds.
Great hustle play. Just didn't see where Amanda was at. Didn't know she was out of bounds as well. But great hustle play right there by Ms. McCallum.
Checking into the ball game for the Maroon and White is number 4, Tony Grace. Deep three by Hunt is good. We're starting to see Hunt come alive in this second half.
And that's what she was doing in that first half, knocking down deep 3 points, and she just knocked down a big one for her.
Long pass from Free is unable to meet Simmons, as we'll have a timeout on the floor by head coach Margaret Richards, wanting to talk this one over as we get into the later part of the fourth quarter. 3:12 remaining here in Normal, Alabama, as the Bulldogs hold on to a 72-59 lead.
First horn.
You know I gotta bring a D block.
Welcome back to Normal as we take a look at our faculty and staff preparing for school to begin next week. Enjoying some maroon and white hoops here at the new event center.
I can't wait till the first game once all the students are back on campus just to see how we'll fill this new event center up.
3-ball is no good by Eagle Chasing as Coach Kim Anderson was looking for the ball to still remain with the Devilettes as she thought the ball was tipped. We'll have a quick substitution here on the floor for head coach Margaret Richards as Bergen will check back into the ball game. The Bulldogs have been held scoreless for the past 2:17. We'll see if they can get something going here. Met with the trap is McCallop. McCallop weaving through, out to Bergen, wide open in a corner. That one falls short. Rebounded by Harlow. Saffold over to Hunt. She'll make the extra pass over to Eagle Chasing. Back to Hunt, deep three, through to contact. She gets it to tickle the twine. 10-point ball game.
She has range. That's the third one she's knocked out from nearly NBA range. So have to find a way to get the ball in her hands. She's single-handedly bringing them back into this game.
She's up to 22 now. We'll see if the Lady Bulldogs can answer. Grace stuck in the trap as we'll have a jump ball. Devilettes basketball.
And that's one thing we can't do with this lead. We can't get too comfortable. There's still 2 minutes left and a lot can happen, so we need to clean this game up for us.
We'll have a timeout here by Coach Kimberly Anderson and the Devilettes, the Lady Bulldogs, still lead by 10, but lots of time left, 72-62. Welcome back to Alabama A&M here at Normal, Alabama. As the Lady Bulldogs hold on to a 10-point lead. Juwan, it's just been a tough one for them during this stretch. The last 3:15, the Lady Bulldogs have been held scoreless as the Devilettes have went on a 12-0 run.
And it's been from defense and shooting from his hand, so we have to get the ball out of our hand and not give up threes like that.
Deep three, contested three, no good from Saffold. As the ladies in maroon and white will bring the ball into the forecourt.
Yeah, man, no need to rush right here. Just get some time off the clock and get a nice shot to end this possession.
Smith dancing, ball over to Cody, over to Simmons, wide open three, to bottom! Big time three from Simmons. Much needed three. Harlow deep inside the paint. Layup rolls around. No good. Rebounded by Simmons. Over to Smith. 1 minute now remaining in the ball game. 13-point lead for the Lady Bulldogs. Smith over to Bergen. Gets a screen from Cody. Nice behind the back by Bergen. Nearly lost the ball. Bergen, cross-court pass to Smith. She'll tee up a three from the corner. That one is no good. Rebounded by Simmons. Simmons will bring the ball out. As the shot clock will refresh. Cody is fouled by Harlow, as that will do it for Harlow today. As that will be her fifth.
Man, it's been a tough one for her. She's done her usual on the boards with 10 rebounds, but with her being in and out of the game so much with that foul trouble, she wasn't even able to knock a field goal now, ending the game with 1 point.
Checking game for Harlow is going to be number 22. Gillery. At the line for the ladies in maroon and white is number 34, and Jayla Cody. Cody has had a solid game today for head coach Margaret Richards and staff.
Yeah, 8 points, eight rebounds. Wait, 9 points now, eight rebounds with four blocks to match that. She's been doing a good job of holding the paint down.
Second of the pair is good as she extends this lead to 15. As the shot clock is turned off, that will pretty much do it here. As we'll have an offensive foul. Foul's going to be charged to Saffold on the drive. Ran right into the body of Free. The Lady Bulldogs look to cruise to their second victory in 2023, but also in the conference.
Yeah, and it would be Miss Monty to get the pretty much last play we have here in this game. She's been the key point in this win for us with 21 points, 5 rebounds, and 3 threes and match that as well. Just like you said, a great win for us, second one of the year, second one in the SWAC, and that's going to move us up in the standings.
As we can now look ahead, the Lady Bulldogs will be hitting the road to Mississippi as they'll have a quick road stand against Alcorn State as well as Jackson State, Lady Tigers. And then they'll come back and head to Mobile as they will take on the Lady Hornets of Alabama State University, that school in Montgomery as most recognize it to be here in Normal, Alabama. And then they'll come back that Saturday to take on the Texas Southern Lady Tigers.
Yeah, they're going on a little road trip and then playing that first game of the new classic we're having. They won't be playing them here at home this season, but it'll still be considered a home game for our Lady Bulldogs. So we'd like to see how we bounce back with us having two games here at home with a dub.
And a much-needed win. That will now make it 3 in a row. Three of their last four, to be correct. Excuse me. As that will do it. The Lady Bulldogs catch fire in the second half, all starting with great defense and turning into amazing offense as they had a single one-possession lead. To start the third quarter, they turned it up and turned it up with points, dime of a dozen, and the unselfishness definitely paid off today as the Lady Bulldogs take care of business here at home, 77-62. Don't touch that dial yet, as we'll be awaiting head coach Margaret Richards joining us here to talk about the great win here at home. as the Lady Bulldogs pull it off 77-62. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as the Lady Bulldogs take care of business here to start the SWAC conference play. Second game, second win in a row, Coach, for you guys to start off 2023. How is that feeling for you guys to start the year off this way?
I mean, it's awesome. I mean, we've been working hard, doing all the little things that we can do to help this team get better, and it's paying off. You know, we got a group of girls that's buying in. You know, as I said in the beginning, we was new. We had to figure out the chemistry, but I see all of that clicking, and we still got a ways to go, but I see them getting better each and every game.
Now, Coach, you guys had a tremendous game today defensively. We know despite the win, you guys are always looking for room to improve, and it seemed like you guys had a tougher time with the second chance points and also the offensive rebounding by the Golden Lions, and I know you guys weren't too happy in that, but today you guys dominated. Was a difference between night and day. What did you preach to the ladies with that one-day break in between today's games?
Well, we always talk about defensive rebounding because those are two things that you can control. Those are effort things, attitude and effort things. You know, you may not make shots, but you can go to the boards and get second chance points. You can get rebounds, and you can play good defense. So,
Juwan,
that was very important for me today.
Very.
Now, we're second in the SWAC in defensive points game, but we had our best offensive performance this season with the most points we scored and the most 3 points we made this season. How big was the three-point shooting, especially early in the game, for us to help extend that lead in the game?
Well, like I said, the young ladies been working hard, and I preach to them. I'm more excited about the 19 assists. I preach to them about sharing the basketball because we are a team. It's not one player that's going to get us over that hump. It took a team effort, and we step up. They shoot those shots in practice, so they have the green light to shoot those shots in the game. and I want them to shoot them those shots with confidence, and tonight they displayed that.
Yeah, and speak on those 19 assists. There was a lot of good ball movement plays. We had one on that and one down there, and a couple for some open threes, especially right. the one for Imani Free, who had a career game herself with 21 points. How big was her on the offensive side for y'all this game today?
I mean, Imani Free is special. You know, I'm so tough on her being a fifth-year senior. I need her to be the leader on and off the floor and just, you know, continue to get better. You know, she can shoot the ball really well, and she's a very smart player. She makes people around her better as well. So that's why I'm extremely tough on her, but I'm not surprised. I think she has a lot of room to grow, and I think she has a lot to show us, you know, moving forward.
Definitely, Coach. 21 points, 7 of 14 from the field. 50% from the three-point line as well, and a perfect shooting performance from the free throw line. Can't explain how great her game was today. How dangerous can this ball club be going now later on into the conference play? How dangerous do you think they can be going now towards tournament play?
Again, if we want to commit to playing defense and getting rebounds, I think we can be pretty dangerous. You know, this group of young ladies can shoot the ball when we're focused and when our feet are set. But if we continue to commit to playing defense and rebound the ball, I think we can be pretty dangerous.
And, Coach, I also want to give your younger players some love, too, between Cody and Imagine.
Yes.
You know, Imagine had a tough senior season as her senior career was cut short yes. due to injury.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like she's been able to bounce back healthily, and she's been a great addition to you guys and learning from your older players as well. How great was it to see the younger players between Imagine as well as Cody show up today like they did?
Oh, I love it. I mean, I think Imagine is going to be special. She's young. She's a young talent. She's tough. I can coach her hard, and she just responds. And that's a coach's dream. You know, she has a very bright future. She makes smart decisions, and she's selfless. I love a point guard that's selfless. And she did a lot of great things today, and she make people around her better as well.
Coach, Juwan, last thoughts?
Now, we have two big road games in Mississippi coming up, another one in Mobile that's considered a home game, but another one. How big is getting these two here home good for us before we go on a road trip like that?
Ooh, this is huge. This is huge. You know, I got my 24-hour rule, and I'm going to celebrate because it is back to work tomorrow.
That's right.
We got a tough road trip. We got a talented Alcorn team that won the most non-conference game. And, of course, we got the number one Jackson State, the SWAC champions,
right.
for 3 years in a row. So we got to put our hard head on, and it's going to be rough on the road. But I told these babies anything is possible if you believe.
Absolutely, Coach. And we're looking forward to seeing your babies and your staff take this trip to Mississippi and bring it to these teams. As we know, it's always been a treat to watch you guys play Alcorn and Jackson as well. Despite however the outcomes come out, you guys have been able to play them hard and play them tough, and we look forward to seeing you guys come back here against Texas Southern on the 21st. For Coach and Juwan, we'd like to say thank you all for joining us here on the live stream. Don't touch that dial yet. Men's basketball will be coming right up after the break. It's the Alabama A&M Athletics YouTube live stream. The women's basketball team take care of business. We'll be right back after a break.
Thank you.